My name's Clay Newcomb and I'm the publisher of Bear Hunting Magazine. This week we're gonna give a dummy's guide to Pacific salmon. I started doing some hunting in Alaska a few years ago and had to learn a lot. We don't have salmon in Arkansas. We're gonna be giving away a bottle of Northwoods Gold Rush. This is a fryer grease additive. Tell us why you want this. Jed, people don't know how to take me without a beard. They either think I'm an insurance agent or a woman. People are gonna be like, what's this guy from Arkansas know about salmon? And I'm like, I didn't know anything about salmon until I researched it and caught some. You look tired. When I started hunting Alaska, I was thrown in headfirst into the world of Pacific salmon, and I'm just starting to learn my way around. Salmon eggs are laid in fresh water in the fall, usually in small streams with gravel bars. Salmon lay their eggs in the same water system they were hatched. The eggs overwinter in the fresh water, hatch in the spring, and then the fry head towards the ocean. Fish that do this are called anadromous. Some species stay in fresh water for up to 2 years after they hatch, while others head directly to the ocean. Salmon use energy reserves to travel far distances during spawning, making them unusually rich in omega-3 fatty acids, making them an almost supernatural source of protein. While in Alaska on two different fall brown bear hunts, I was able to fish in the mouths of these small streams that flowed into these larger rivers. One of the hunts was in late August, the other was early September, and these streams were packed with hundreds, if not thousands, of silver and some pink salmon. Man, this is a big silver salmon, a big male. What a spectacular fish. We released almost every fish we caught except for a few that hadn't fully turned into their spawning colors. The deeper you get into the fall, the more the fish start to lose their fitness and literally start to rot while they're still alive. All these fish end up dying. They give all their energy towards spawning and don't eat anything. As I understand it, them striking a lure is an aggressive breeding response, not a feeding response. There are five species of Pacific salmon. The king or Chinook, these are the big silver colored ones and can weigh over 100 pounds. In the Yukon River, kings run over 1,900 miles to spawn, making this the longest salmon spawning route. Sockeye, also known as red, these males turn bright red in the spawn and can weigh over 15 pounds. Coho, also known as silver, are silver in the ocean, and during the spawning, they turn a brilliant red. Their teeth and jaws become hooked, especially the males. During spawning, they can weigh over 20 pounds. This is primarily what I caught on both my trips. Pink or humpy salmon is the second most common Pacific salmon. It's the smallest in size. Males develop a hump and a hooked beak when spawning. They can be bright red or more dull during spawning. They can weigh up to 15 pounds. Chum or dog salmon are the most common salmon. They're usually tri-colored, and the meat is considered the least desirable and has been traditionally used for dog food. Can weigh over 20 pounds. Salmon are a vital part of the Alaskan ecosystem for bears, birds, and humans, and really everything. I count it a privilege that this Arkansas boy has gotten to partake in the cycle. There are currently a lot of challenges in salmon conservation, and many agencies and groups are doing a lot to preserve them. Thanks for joining the conservation this week at the Bear Hunting Magazine Global Headquarters. We're gonna be headed to Saskatchewan for one final spring bear hunt. Tell us again why you want this Northwoods Bear Products Gold Rush. Keep the wild places wild.